Can you show us your guitar? It's a very strange. At first, it has been a very strange sound. What kind of guitar is this?
This is a National guitar. It was this particular model was made, I think, in 1933-34. And at the time, there were two different guitar makers. This is a metal-bodied guitar. It's not wood. It looks like wood, but it's
tin.
It's metal. Yeah, tin. Metal. Yeah, metal with a resonator.
Yeah. What is this inside? This is a resonance kind of resonance.
It's a metal, a metal plate, yeah. Resonator, yeah. Like a kazoo.
Ah, yeah.
They use in skiffle and jazz. Dobro and National made these guitars.
Do you use a special technique to play this guitar, or it's quite normal like another guitar?
Well, they were made for Hawaiian guitar. They were played like this style.
Yeah, the first, yes.
But they were made really for street singers, street blues singers, because they were very low. They were sort of like an acoustic amplifier, you know.
I think another direction is without that resonance thing.
Yeah,
is a steel guitar then. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But very few of the blues singers used it on their knees. I think Bucker White and the Reverend, what's his name, Wilkins, the guy who wrote Prodigal Son, the Rolling Stones recording song.
Yeah.
He played it on it. Well, no, in fact, he played a Gibson acoustic on his knees. I do sometimes play this way, but normally I play it up this way. For electric playing, I use...
Glass?
Glass. This is an aspirin bottle from America. It's like $1.47 or something. You throw out the aspirin, you wash the bottle, and it's great.
Good sound for $1 and...
Yeah, but... For this kind of guitar, it's better to play metal.
Yeah. All right. Can you show us how
to try it?
We call it plectrum. What do you call this in English?
A plectrum.
Plectrum, yeah. And but your fingers too.
My fingers as well.
Can you show for our viewers which are playing guitar?
Yeah. Well, for the reload.
What do you do with the plectrum?
This?
The deeper.
The way to play is with a thumb pick on here and two metal picks. Sometimes I play like this, but normally I play with the plectrum because I play so much much electric guitar that I get so used to this style and stick with it.
Did you start your guitar playing with several instruments, some different kinds of guitars, or do you start with electric guitar?
No, I saw
what has been your first guitar?
Acoustic guitar.
Yeah?
Yeah, very, very
a
cheap.
Normal?
Yeah. Yeah, cheap, ordinary, £3 guitar.
Yeah.
Just playing Lonnie Donegan, skiffle, you know the sort of songs.
Mm.
And later on, I got electric, played Buddy Holly type material. And then later on, rhythm and blues, rock, what have you, you know.
Where did you get that influences to play electric guitar? You know, the change from the acoustic to the electric guitar?
Buddy Holly, Eddie Cochran.
Do you listen to radio?
Yeah, just radio.
Yeah?
I didn't have records. I didn't have records for years.
But how you remember? You must have listened very often to the radio, or they played them very often, yeah?
Yeah. Well,
did
in
you
Ireland,
write it down or something else?
Well, I mean, I learned all the songs the skiffle players, the Vipers, Wally White and the Vipers, Chas McDevitt, George Melly and the Bubbling Over Four, Lonnie Donegan and his skiffle group. I learned all these songs, and they were doing Woody Guthrie songs, Lead Belly, some Big Bill Brunsey songs, bluesy kind of stuff. But later on, I kind of got into Eddie Cochran, Buddy Holly, Gene Vincent, and so I realized that besides acoustic, you had to have.
Is this your acoustic background? You've got all that names you.
Yeah, I guess so. Mm. But being an Irishman, I mean, we're very very attached to acoustic instruments anyway. You know.
What are the? How do you choose now your material you are playing today? What are the criteria, so what do you call?
Well, I just write songs. I mean, songs just crop out of the blue. When I'm back in Ireland or in London or somewhere, a riff comes off the guitar and I say, oh, that's something, and I just get some lyrics with it, and next thing's a song. But the best kind of songs are where they just hit you, and they're lyrics and music at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is it a kind of feeling?
Yeah, absolutely. It's just something out of the blue, you know.
Yeah. You play a lot of blues. And my question is, where did you get your blues? Where?
I don't think you get it from anywhere. What? You're born with it. Yeah? You're born with a love for that feeling or that mood that the blues gives you. Mm. And I don't think it has to be a purist sort of approach, or it has to be sort of academic. I mean, you just feel that you want to express yourself in a more sort of moody way through the instrument and vocally. I don't think it's essentially an American thing or a European. You just do it. I mean, I couldn't just kind of go. It's just a happy thing all the time. Certain times you just want to go express the sort of sad emotions within you. And that's what the blues comes in.
When did you start it with that, to express yourself and your mood? You have a sad mood in the blues. Can you remember?
I can't remember a particular date, but I mean, I remember that, after listening to a lot of rock and roll and folk music, that rock is great because it gives you all that energy. You can kind of express all that drive and so on, and the folk has got a certain sort of, it kind of covers like the history of your country or your mood or whatever. But the blues really kind of, I mean, folk song, you, I mean, that's, it's so, like, it's unethical. It doesn't really, I mean, the blues thing, you can do an introduction for an album for 10 minutes. Sometimes you don't even feel like singing. You just keep it.
Is the blues only in your soul, or is the blues also in the surrounding? Do you realize that the surrounding you're living in? Where did you get the feelings?
Well, I don't claim to be like the European answer to the blues message. I mean, I just identify with these blues players, and I think that that emotion is in Europe as well. And I don't try and sort of emulate or try and sort of be the new Big Bill Brunsey or Muddy Waters. I just they've got something that we've probably missed out on in Europe, where until the last 20 years or something.
Has the blues something to do with the suppressed people and any kind of suppression? Or is it only a private thing?
Both, I think. Oh. I don't know. I don't sort of claim to be a suppressed person or a very private person. It's a mixture of, it's lots of things. And like you find Americans who aren't exactly sort of suppressed in the normal sort of sense of the word. I mean, just some people, they just want to do something that isn't premeditated and planned, and they don't want to sort of go just something premeditated. They just want to kind of, and strangely enough, a lot of the blues numbers have strange tunings and strange ways of playing them to kind of conjure up this mood, and you just kind of, and the
blues, I think, from what I know, was the first music which actually introduced sort of bending notes, bending strings. Mm. And the only European that I know was Django Reinhardt, the jazz guitar player, the Belgium guitar player. He used to start bend notes and things. Mm-hmm. But the blues isn't the only kind of music in the world. It just happens to be the cornerstone of the real honest hard.
You are two playing different kind of music. I think if the first, your acoustic set has some different roots of the music. Some reminds me on boozing songs. Yeah. Do you think they are all blues what you sing with your acoustic thing?
I don't know. I don't really sort of sit down and say this is going to be like six songs of blues. I don't. No. That's not important. I mean, you just. All right. Some of the songs are obviously very blues rooted, but yeah. I don't want to become like too academic and too sort of technical. So this is a blues song, and I play only these songs, and that's the blues. I mean, the blues being a folk music has all the kind of elements creeping in all the way, you know.
Do you know other ways for you to express yourself, or is this in the music you are doing, or do you know other ways to express yourself? I mean, what do you feel, what do you think, is that runs that
well, that's
in
not
the
everything
music?
I do. I mean, I express myself in other ways, not only in music, but music is my big kind of outlet. But I do a little bit of drawing and painting and God knows what. But I mean, music is my big interest, yeah. Mm.
Are you satisfied with your life?
I'm satisfied with my life. I mean, in as much as I can play to people and I can play what I want, and I've got a guitar and an amplifier and we can travel around, that's fantastic. Mm. I mean, I'm not 100% happy with the way I play and perform. I'm working, I want to be better as a musician. Mm. But I feel I'm very lucky to be able to tour and play and see different cities and live out of a suitcase, you know. I think it's great. I love that, you know.
Yeah. Is this your old electric guitar?
Yes.
First one? No.
The first, well, second electric guitar.
Yeah.
The first one cost.
And how old?
About a third of the price or something, or less. This one is, I think it's 1959, 1960. I bought it second hand in 1962, 63. It's still going.
It's a pity without an amplifier. You got very old amplifiers.
Yeah, I've got a Fender Bassman amplifier with 1955, four 10-inch speakers.
Where can you get this amplifiers? It's very hard to find it.
Well, in America, you know, guys just show up and they know you're interested in old amplifiers and they just...
And you organized some...
Yeah. Well, you know, you get to know certain dealers in old amplifiers and guitars, and they show up and they say, "Do you want this one?" And
oh yeah.
But they're good. They're not as technical as the new amps. They don't have like phasing and tremolo and echo and so on. But they got that warmth and that drive, you know. Mm.
Do you think that your audience expect a special kind of music, perhaps a Rory Gallagher music? I don't know. And change this, the expectations of the audience. Are there the same expectations 1968 like now, today, 1976? Do you have to do more rock? Do you have to be harder?
I don't think so. I don't know. I mean, it's very, very hard to say when you're touring. You know, you make a record and obviously they expect to hear some of the new songs and some of the old ones. Mm. It's very, very hard for me to say. Mm. I don't feel that we have to kind of bend this way or that way, more rocky, more bluesy. We just do a mixture. But we don't see it as a mixture ourselves. We just kind of, if a song has a blues feel, we play it that way. Or if it's a rocky thing, we do it that way. Or if it's an acoustic thing, we do it that way. And just try and be as honest as we can with the music.
Mm.
Without getting all sort of...
Has the business become harder? The rock business?
But it's so the business kind of improves for people. I mean, you get better dressing rooms, better lighting. Things improve in that scale, but it becomes a little more of a rat race. But I mean, you know, depends on how involved you get, or how much you want to get involved. You know.
My last question: some guys use you as an idol, or you are on a lot of walls on a poster. Yeah, guitar playing hero. And you, for some people, you are an idol. For some young people, does that mean anything to you, to be an idol?
I don't think about it. I mean, if people like me that much, great. I mean, when I was starting off, I had pictures of people on the wall at home, and I used to look at them and say, "I wish I could play like him." I think it's healthy. I don't think it's. I mean, I don't sort of sit at home and say, "Fantastic." I mean, I know I have a lot to learn and a lot to play. I don't stop long enough to say, a lot of people have my photograph. It's not. I've still so much I want to learn and play and achieve on the instrument and on record and with the band that I don't. It's not important, but it's a nice boost to say that people like what you do. But also,
good feeling.
It is, but it also gives you kind of a sort of a duty to kind of be as good as they want you to be. You know.
Right. Thank you very much that you have been with us.
Thank you. Bye.